San Jordi, home to the gymnastics competition here at the Olympic Games. Tonight, it is the final of the women's team competition. For the standings in the women's team competition after the compulsories, which count 50%. And you see it is close there. The unified team in first place, United States in second by 0.5. And the United States will be on uneven bars first, the unified team on vault. Then they rotate. The United States goes to the balance beam. Unified team to balance beam, United States to floor exercise.
Uneven bars is not Kim's strongest event. If she can get through this, I think she's home free.
I remind you, she had such a disaster at compulsories when right in the middle of her beam routine, she just seemingly stepped off and lost her balance.
And it was the first event in the compulsories.
So much pressure on here at the games. How does the next Mary Lou?
She's hit both her release moves. She basically just has her dismount.
Gotta stick though, right here.
Oh, again, another hop.
9.90, a terrific score. Welcome back. Shannon Miller is on the uneven bars for the Americans. Kim Zmeskal has already scored a near perfect 9.9.
She's doing well. She already hit her opening combination. This is one great bar routine. There's her second release move. She has a big dismount plan.
There. Now compare that for me to Zmeskal, who just got a 9.9.
No question that routine was far more difficult than Zmeskal's.
Here's the dismount, Elfie.
It was just a little bit too close to the high bar, but what was so important is that she didn't give away 1/10 to the judges. Now she does this out of some full work at the top, very quick twist, stands it up nicely.
9.950 for Shannon Miller. Oh boy, and this is the Belarusian swan, Svetlana Boginskaya. She's won 4 Olympic medals, 6 world championship medals, 8 European championship medals.
Of course, all she has to focus in on is that landing. She knows that she'll get a better score as long as she sticks.
Yeah, and she answers. She answers back with a perfect landing and the body position in the air. It just doesn't get any better than this. There's the round off. Look at her legs are glued together. Beautiful laid out position. Looks for the floor and just nails it. She got a lot more height on this second vault. That's beautiful. And of course, this is what the judges are seeing.
This is their view.
The blind approach to the horse, very difficult vault. And there's her trademark. See the 1 foot in front of the other.
And her score from the 6 judges, a 9.950. We will be able to have standings for you for the teams after they finish this first rotation of 4. Christina Bontosz.
Actually, John, she had the highest score in the compulsory exercises, which was quite surprising. If you remember, she had some problems, some real wobbles on this event, and she ended up as the highest score on this apparatus, so she is very good on optional beam.
She is from Onești, Romania, the same town as the legendary Romanian Nadia Comăneci. Actually, Nadia was her national junior team coach from 1986 to 87 at the National Training Center in Deva.
We've already seen her, however, play it a little bit safe. She was supposed to continue the elements after she mounted the beam, but decided to take a break and align herself.
You can see her pausing just a little bit, getting set for another very difficult acrobatic skill. 2 layouts in the rope. We've been seeing a lot of those skills throughout this competition. Again, giving away 10th for the judges.
We are just getting started in the women's team final competition, which will decide the gold medal. After one rotation of 4, the unified team still ahead of the United States by 2/10 of a point more than it was before we began this. Romania in 3rd place, China in 4th. And here's the other battle we were talking about, the all-around scores after one rotation. Kim, actually Carrie Strug, is in third place, and Kim Semesco has moved up into fourth. If she gets into the top three, she advances to the all-around. If she stays there in fourth, she will not. Kim needs a 9.987 to move into third place. This is the event that she's the world champion on. This is the event that she fell on. Compulsories, let's watch. Bella Caroli's voice you hear in the background.
The dismount, if she sticks, she just might do it, and she does. Wow, that was for the scene of her life.
That's not supposed to be.
The only one at this point who understands just how important that final move is. Double back, perfect.
And she doesn't just do it, she nails it.
Sit here with us at the Olympic Games and wait for Kim Zemeskal's score on balance beam. There it is, a 9.912.
Possibly the most difficult beam routine in the competition.
You know, you don't see those little wobbles that often from Shane Miller.
We saw Dominique do three layouts in a row. Shannon also does it right here.
Oh. Again, great, but I remember her in the rehearsal on podium. She was having problems out here in the competition hall. Whoa, again, another big break. She was supposed to hold that handstand for at least 2 seconds.
Let's put this team competition in perspective for you. For the Americans in particular, the last time the U.S. women's team won a team medal, any medal, in a non-boycott Olympics was 1948, and it was a bronze.
John, she has a lot of big tricks in this routine, and this is a big dismount, especially the landing. She handled it fairly well, but again, took a step to the side.
A 9.90 for Shannon Miller. So a couple of good scores from the unified team.
She has such a beautiful swing on this apparatus. She makes it look so easy. There's a full twist to handstand in her first release move. A little bit close.
You know, her tall, slender frame really does give her a much different look than the other competitors, doesn't it?
It just seems like it takes so much longer for her to reach the handstands. She's swinging well.
Whoa, that is very uncharacteristic for Boginskaya. You're usually seeing her just nail those dismounts.
And her score, a 9.862 on uneven bars for the unified team. After that, Tatiana Gutsu from Odessa in the Ukraine.
She is just the evil Knievel of gymnastics. She'll just knock your socks off.
Look how quickly she moves from the high bar to the low bar. Already the speed is a major difference. Second release move.
The gymnast has 3 minutes to warm up.
This is a gymnast, by the way, with attitude. She stunned a lot of people.
Look at that.
Whoa.
Gorgeous.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Boy, oh boy.
A new trend. The women are starting to do this double laid out somersault. The speed she needs to generate to flip her body twice in a stretched position.
And her score was a 9.962. We bring you now the standings after two rotations of four. The United States has now dropped to third place following their performance on the balance beam. Romania moved up into second. Unified team still up there in gold medal position. 9.837. What do you think, Elfie?
I think Kim's floor, if she hits it, will be much higher. There's no question about that.
It's Svetlana Boginskaya on the beam. Take a look.
And John, this is definitely one routine you cannot miss. We talk about Svetlana being such an artist. This is where she really shines through on this apparatus. Great acrobatic skill, two consecutive layouts.
There has been some bad blood between Boginskaya and American Kim Zmeskal during the awards ceremony for the World Championships. Svetlana was booed when she refused to shake Kim's hand, but Zmeskal had done the same thing to her the day before during the vault ceremony, and you perhaps will see Boginskaya and Zmeskal go head to head in the individual all-around. Crowd applauding the floor exercise routine as Svetlana wrapped up her beam routine here. Here's a dismount.
And watch here, she just nails this dismount.
Svetlana Boginskaya, that was her beam routine. Not only one of the best gymnasts on the unified team, but also really the team mother, always taking care of the younger gymnasts.
And what a credit to this athlete. Her scores are big scores for the unified team. There's her opening double layout run, and her dismount was spectacular. As Tim said, she just nails the landing. Big score for the unified team.
9.925 is what she got on balance beam. And listen to the whistles that the judges got. They were expecting, the crowd was, a higher score than that. Oh!
Can't believe it.
Did not even get successfully onto the beam. This is just shades of Kim Zmeskal in the compulsories.
And the sad thing here is this team is six deep. I mean, she may not even make the individual all-around final because only three will advance.
Have never watched her compete. They don't own a television set. It's actually a good thing they did not see what happened at the beginning here. She has to keep her concentration. She has to finish the routine.
This is really sad. This is one tough mount, round off layout on. Obviously not a lot of room for error. She was right off the beam, but even after the fall, she threw everything in the book. Look at this dismount, takes the whole length of the beam, ends with a full twisting double back. That was really the highlight
she
right there.
She knew right then and there that it was gonna be tough.
A low score, 9.425. Reminds you that, only the top three gymnasts on each team will advance to the individual all-around. She was in such a great position to compete later in the week. whose life was passing before her on the beam. You heard Shannon Miller's floor exercise music. Here is that routine.
European judges favored this type of work.
A 9.90 on floor exercise. Up on floor, Kim Zemeskal. She had the fall on beam, needs a 9.912 to move into third place among the U.S. gymnasts. And what that means is if she can move into third place, she will advance, she will not carry Strug out, and advance to the individual all around. Coming up, a 9.925. So Zemeskal, entering the last rotation, has moved into third place. Strug is in fourth. Back here at the Palau San Jordan, if they ended this competition right now, Kim Zemeskal in third position would be going to the individual all-around competition. Here are the team standings, and the United States continues to fall further behind Romania. They were in second place, of course, after the compulsories to the unified team. Now they're in third. Here really is a big surprise for the unified team. Rosa Galieva. People from these republics, because it's no longer the Soviet Union, will be competing for their own republics in the individual all around. So if she were to win, the flag of Uzbekistan would run down.
little Rosa Galeva.
This fella root for Shannon Miller is next up.
Oh, golly. Just that little bit of a slide on that landing. But she knows you can't give those tents away like that.
Right now, Svetlana Boginskaya for exercise.
Has acquired a variety of nicknames during her career, including the Queen of Perfection, and the Belarusian Swan is also known as the Goddess of Gymnastics.
Super block, lift, lift. Watch for the landing.
Trying to see if she can stay in third position ahead of Carrie Strug. Her teammate needs a 9.936. She will advance to the all-around.
Apparatus. We've seen her score two tens as recently as the Olympic trials in Baltimore, and with that vault she probably could do a little bit better on her second vault.
But you know, what a fighter. Right from the start she was in trouble at these Olympic Games, but she has battled back every inch of the way.
Judges are scoring her first vault. She takes the... Oh, look at this, a 9.937, 1/1000th of a point ahead of what she needed. So she is assured. The crowd is booing because they wanted a higher score, but she is insured at third position. She doesn't know it.
Oh, and better vault, much better vault.
This is typical of Sim.
And what of Carrie Strug?
Good job.
So powerful on the second vault. This is exactly what Kim does, and she does it so well. Beautiful stretched laid out position and just nails
it. Out of compulsories in fifth position and has just scratched her way up into third. A 9.950, so indeed higher than the first vault. Assured of that third position, she will advance to the individual all around. In a similar fight on her team, the unified team is Tatiana Gutsu. She would need virtually close to a perfect 10 to make the top three on her team. She knows it. Here is her routine.
Well, she really gave it all that she had, but I think Tatiana Gutsu knows that if she's looking for a 10, it's not going to happen tonight.
Big hug from the team mother, really, Svetlana Bukinskaya. Tatiana's in tears.
I
think it doesn't hurt to make a mistake in the competition of your life. In the arms of Svetlana Boginskaya, Tatiana Kutsu scores a 9.925, a terrific score, but on a team with so much depth. This unified team has won 9 team competitions in the Olympic Games. And so as you see, Gutsu in 4th position on the unified team. All-around scores for the Americans. Semeskal just beats out Carrie Strug. So, the unified team with gold, Romania silver, United States bronze. Admire the courage of Kim Semeskal, facing the demon that on Sunday almost cost her her Olympic dream. Getting back on the beam tonight and then proving that her Olympic dream was no longer a nightmare. And what of Shannon Miller? Never the big story in the newspapers, not the big shot of gymnastics. But tonight, Cinderella and the slipper fit. Can there be anything so graceful, so beautiful as the Belarusian swan, Svetlana Boginskaya? She showed that she could captain her team to gold as a leader. And then comfort her young as a mother. How bittersweet a night for Kim Semeskal. In the arms of the man who made her dream come true on the night he told the world it was time for him to leave. Yes, tonight was Kim's night, her Olympic night, the night of her young life. But tonight, as the Olympic anthem plays, instead of the one they grew up with and competed with, the unified team are reminded that they will now exit the system that trained and built their unbeatable program, really. And when next time they compete, it will be for their home republics. Svetlana Boginskaya, the dynasty that has fashioned the most unbeatable teams in the history of women's Olympic gymnastics. Well, it's now being dismantled and will be scattered across the four corners of what was the Soviet Union. Seeing again the faces of Svetlana Boginskaya and little Tatiana Gutsu, we're reminded this was an emotional night for everyone in this arena, a night to remember.